I forgot what I told him, and it relieved his stomach, because I was like, all you gotta do is live for God. I swear, I lied to you now.
That's right.
He was like, okay, I mean, that made me feel better, but I mean, all that other stuff just, it's real. I was like, but I was just a little bit. I was like, yeah, Mel, you think like what's going on now is what's bad? Nah, it's gonna get way worse. I'm like, you think the stuff on TV like three-headed dragons? I'm trying to tell you, them things right.
They're gonna be coming about that sea, you know.
That's right. It's coming, and let me tell you, but let me, can I show you something beautiful? People who have never witnessed are starting to witness. You see how God
okay, now we both said
that. Put it in your mind. See, that's why you don't have time to be on Facebook looking at fat butts, gentlemen. You better be getting some word in your spirit.
I'll be on Facebook.
You gotta be careful, you know, because you don't have time. When you consume with those things that are pulling you away from God and away from His Word, when you consume with that stuff, what happens is somebody's gonna come along right in your weak spirit, right in your weak mind, and tell you something, shake your faith, and you'll walk away from the church and be lost.
Snake right in there, for real. Snake right in there.
You hear him? That's how he does it. But if you are available, and if you really want to, trust me, there are gonna be a lot more opportunities for everybody in this room. Because the time is winding up. God is like, I need to use every willing vessel. If you're in Bible study and you really want to live for God, He's going to use you very, very soon, if not tomorrow. He's going to use you to what knowledge you already have. You may not know all the answers. You do have a testimony, one. Oh. And number two.
Oh, right there.
Only talk about that if right you don't there. Know the answer, say, you know what? I don't know the answer to that, but I'm going to go and study. Bring it back to Bible study. We'll hash it out together. We'll talk about it. I'll give you the answer to be able to go back. People put you under the pressure because you can't answer it right now. No, no, man, I'm still growing just like you. What's your question? I bet you when I come back, I'll have an answer. And God is faithful because He wants His people saved. He will give us the answer to the question. And when you stand back,
He will, though.
They better know that stuff. You see, He will give you the answer. If you could just be have enough courage to step into the ring. Yep. Black people do not like to have these kinds of intelligent conversations.
Ooh.
We scared to even have a conversation.
God's like, that make me feel like I'm stupid because I ain't having no intelligent conversation.
You hear what I'm saying? But we all been there. We're all starting. At our starting place, we all been there. God is like, listen, I'll fight for you. I'll give you what to say in that very hour. All you got to do is just be willing to say something.
You're getting the ticket in the chair.
You see? Just be willing to say something for me. Be willing. Just, you may not know all the answers. Let them laugh. Let them be like, oh, you don't even know what you're talking about. You know what? I don't know everything, but I'm growing. But I do know in my heart of hearts, my mind of mind, that this is what's up, and this is what I do know. I do know that Jesus, what even historians agree, that a man named Jesus lived.
Because that was one thing.
History records in different languages on different countries that a man named Jesus actually lived. Do you see? You could start there. So even historians who not in the Bible, who don't know anything, who don't even claim to be Christians, they agree that a man named Jesus lived. I believe the things that are recorded about him. And this is my proof. And you come back, let's talk about it. That's called apologetics. It sounds like I'm being sorry for something. But apologetics doesn't mean you're sorry about what you believe. It means you can defend it without arguing and causing, like, you're not supposed to be going, you're going there. No, we're not supposed to be going back, going to blows about what we believe. But you should be able to have an intelligent conversation. So what we're going to do for the next couple weeks, let's come together and let's equip ourselves with the answers we're going to need to give people when they come to us. Okay. You better have an answer.
That's Jesus. I mean, that's God's son. It's the difference. And they were like, well, what's the name? What's God's name? I was like, he got different ones, and I just happen to say Jehovah. That's the one I know.
That's good. No, no, you hold on to that. You're looking at this clock first day of school, and I ain't even braiding no hair tonight. But let me tell you something. These are questions. That's our first question. Let's deal with that. That's what we'll do with next week.
That should be in Genesis.
You see what I'm saying? Oh, it's so much. We'll come back. Her question, she was like, just the names of God. Jesus, Jehovah,
Yahweh,
Jesus God,
Alpha,
what about
Omega.
His name? You see what I'm saying?
I said some other ones, but I didn't know.
All of Jehovah's.
Bring it. Let's deal with it. If you know if you text me, email me, see me offline, and I'll give you my information. You see what I'm saying? And I gonna email me and say, oh, Sister Keisha, so-and-so just asked me about blah, 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 blah. Let's chat about it so I can equip you with the answers. I do not know every single thing. God knows I don't. I would be a liar to tell you I know everything. But what I do know is I do believe I have enough so far, and we can get the rest together to be able to stand and have an intelligent, calm conversation. By the time it's all done. And then whatever we don't know, the Bible promises that Jesus, that God himself, that he will give us what we need to say in that hour.
I have a name because it's like I have a two of my coworkers. One of them, she's a Christian, mm-hmm. and my other coworker, he believes in God,
right,
and everything. But you know, like he's not saved. Like he does whatever he wants to do, whatever. Okay. So like they'll have conversations. And I'm just sitting over to the side, like, I'm not getting into this. You know, because, like, she's, like, they're always, like, going back and forth. And he's the type of person that he always has an answer for everything.
Right.
Like, you know, it's never, like, you know, well, I can see what you're saying. No, it's always, you know. And it's just, like, and she's, like, always going back and forth with him. And I'm, like, just stop. Like, you know, like, if all you can do is just tell him what you believe in.
Right.
This is just me. That's all you can do is just tell them what you believe in your experience.
That's right.
It's on them if they want to receive it.
That's right.
Or not. And I mean, he does say some things that you know, may have you like,
what?
Hmm,
that
I understand. I mean, not understand, but like,
I see that.
That
makes a little bit of sense.
But like, she goes back and forth with him. And then one time she got on me and was like, why didn't you come into the car? I was like, no. Not what I'm going to do. I'm not going to go back and forth.
And the Bible talks about we don't go back. We don't argue about it. We don't. All you got to do is tell. You tell them what you believe. If you have an answer to what they're asking you, hi. Okay, I know we really are. And the little one comes in. But I'm telling you, but you can. God will equip us. And y'all be praying because I want you to be able to walk out empowered.
You know how
you to walk out empowered.
I usually end my arguments. I'm like. Yeah, you know, so we go through the whole little, you know what I'm saying, answering their questions. Well, how you know this? Well, I'm like, well, if you look, da 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 da. Half the time, I don't even know where it comes from. Like, if you ask me now, I wouldn't even remember what I say.
Right.
I'd be in the moment and just be like,
yeah, just come out of you.
Right. But I always end it. I'd just be like, you know what? Okay, if you really feel like I'm wrong, let's both die. If you feel like I'm wrong, let's both die.
Let's go.
Exactly.
Let's see how they can wrap the whole
boat. Right.
Well, sometimes, like, if I get to the point, I just be like, well, research it yourself. You find it, and then you tell me.
That's why I didn't come back.
But that's the point, because a lot of them are like, oh, you know, this is my but that's my thing. I'm like, at the end of the day, I can argue down, you can argue me down. Mm-hmm. But we're not going to find out until we die.
That's right.
Or until he comes back. So
what if you believe in the wrong thing?
Exactly.
Let's pray. Father, we just thank you. We thank you for this class. We thank you, oh God, because you are equipping us. You are setting us up. Not with houses and lands and cars, even though they would be nice, but you're giving us the truth and you're giving us answers. And, oh God, we know that souls matter first. And I pray, Lord, that you give us the anointing and the things that we need. Forgive us for all our sins, anything else that's not right. God, we want to be ready and right for you. If you should come tonight, we want to be ready. Thank you for sending your son Jesus, for dying on the cross for us, for rising and for living in us so that we can answer everybody for the hope that lies in us. We praise you. We thank you. Bring us back here again. We know every power of hell is going to keep us from coming here on Tuesday. But bring us here, oh God, safely and with a mind to learn more about you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Let's get ready. You know everything you need.